Good morning friends, welcome back to the online class. Today we will discuss how to create a query. How to create a query in Access. Okay, now previously we discussed how to what is a query and what is the use of queries and what are the types of queries. Okay, query is a way to ask question about data. Okay, so means what? We can ask any information from the database. So with the help of query, we can easily retrieve any information from the database. There are six types of queries. First one is select, make, table, append, update, cross tab, and delete queries. So these are all the six types of queries which is available in MS Access 2010. Now they will discuss how to create a query in Access. Okay, now see, in the book there are two ways in which we can create a query. First one is query design and second one is query wizard. Okay, the first one today we will discuss query design. Number one is query design. So query design is a way that we can create a query. Okay, now see, let us use the student table for creating a query using query design and query wizard. In your book you can see there is a student's table given here, and this table is used for creating a query with the help of query design and query wizard. So first of all, we have to first discuss now the steps. Okay. Now first you can see the first step, click the query design in the query group on the cross tab button, or you can say click the query design in the query groups on the create tab. After that you can see so kind of box will be opened where you can select the tables in which to create a query. Means first we have to go the query design. First it is query design. And after that we have to click where? Query groups. Query groups. This is number one. Number two. It is so important. Query, getting a query is not an easy task. Okay? It will take time, but the steps is so important. After that, you can group the create tab button. After that, number three is create tab button. There is a button. It is on the top of the query group, and in the queries group you can see a tab that is create tab. You just click the create tab. After that the show table dialog box appears. Means there is dialog box will appear. It is called dialog box. Show dialog box. Show dialog box will appear. Okay, in the show dialog box you can see there are three tabs, tables, queries, and both. There are three tabs. There are basically three tabs, tables, queries, and the last one is both. Last one is both. Okay, now see, in a table, first we have to click here in table. And after that you have to select your table. If you have more than one table, then you have to add these two or three table in the table tab. Okay, for that's why you have to click tables. After that you can see click the table student and then click add. Okay, after selecting the table, select the table first, then click add button. You have to click add button to add the table into your query design. Okay, now dialog box. Okay, now see, after that you click the select the table and after that click the add button. Okay, you can see in the book, or just double click on the table, or just double click on the tables. Okay, now see, for example, if you have two tables, okay, say marks table and details table, not details table, marks table and address table. Okay. From marks table, when you click tables, there is often coming that which table you want to select. First, we have to select marks table. First, marks is coming. And after that, you can select another table. This table address. There are two tables, marks and address. After that, address table will be added in the show dialog box. Okay. After that, if you can repeat these steps to add several related tables. If you can repeat, these steps. If you want to add more than 2, 3, 4, more than one tables, means what? If you have more than one table, say example you have 10 tables, you can repeat these steps. Just select the table and after that click add, or you even double click on the table button. Okay. Now in this way you can first select the tables. After that you can see in the book number 3, close. Click close when you finish dialog box adding the tables. Means what? After selecting the tables, means I have select number 1 marks table and number 2 address table. Okay, I have two tables, then I select these two tables. After that, click the close button. There is a close button. In the close button, we have to click close button to close the dialog box. Okay, now can see, after clicking the close button, the query widget window appears, means the query design window will appear. Means after clicking the close button, there is under dialog box, or under we can say window will appear. This is called query design window. Okay, now you see number 4. Now select the field to be included in the query using one of the following way. Okay, in the query design you can see there is a query design. First, field, table, sort, show and criteria, and last one is on. Okay, there are, you can see there is a query design grid. Means what? After that, query design window will appear. So in query design window, what happened? This is like a query design window. Okay, say example, this is a query design window. Query design window. Okay, in the query design window, what happened? You can see in the book, the student table now select. Okay, I have two tables. First table is what? That is the marks table. And second one is the address table. In the marks table, if I have three fields, say roll number, name, and say class. Okay. In the address table, I have also three tables. Three fields is roll number, address, and name. Okay. Now you can see, this is the second table, address table, and this is the first marks table. Okay. So after that, what happened? You can see in the book. Now select the field to be included in the query using the one of the following way. Now double click on the field, it will place the next available column in the query grid. Okay, after that you will see a query design grid. That is, after selecting the field or after selecting the tables, there is a under window will coming, that is query design grid or query design fields in query design grid. Okay, now see, double click the asterisk button or asterisk to include all the fields on the table. Means what? There is a call asterisk symbol. This is called asterisk symbol. When you select this symbol, it means what? For all,
for all. I want all the columns to be included in the query design. If you want to include all the columns to the query design window or query design grid, in the query design grid, then all the fields will be included if you click asterisk symbol. But if you don't require all the fields in the query design grid, then you can select the particular column or specified column, whatever you want. Okay, now see, type the field name directly in the required column of the grid. Okay, you can also type the field name also. Say, roll number, name, class, and address I want. Directly you can write the column name, or you can say, you can just select the roll number, name, class, and address. Because see, the roll number here, same roll number. Name here and this name, same name. Because this roll number means what? It is a unique key. It is a primary key in the two tables. So this primary key means what? It is a foreign key. I have already told you that the foreign key is used to create a relationship between both the tables or more than one tables. So this is a foreign key, roll number, and this is roll number. Is what? It is a foreign key. Okay, I can see. You can arrange the field in the order you want then to appear in the query result. Okay. To change the order, select the entire column and drag it to the required position. Means what? If you want to you can design yourself. Means if you want to design that the roll number should be come after the names. Okay, you can design. This is up to you, whatever you want. But the basic thing is that which table or field and which information you want, then just you select the information and the field name. Okay, after that you can see to hide one or more fields, clear the show checkbox for those fields. Shows the checkbox clear for a percentage and grid. Okay, now if you want to hide one or more table, then you have to select this field checkbox. It is called checkbox. It is called checkbox. If you select it, tick it means what? You select the field. But if you unselect it means what? You don't want to enter the field in the query design grid. Okay? Now you can see next page. You can see after that what happened. Choose the field to sort by the shoes ascending or descending from the corresponding sort dialog box. Okay, now you can also ascending or descending with the help of a sort box. S-O-R-T, sort box. So sort box, there is a sort box where you can arrange your field name or field's value in ascending order or descending order. Okay, if you want to ascending order, say like A to Z, you want, or descending order means what? Z to A. Whatever you want, you can arrange this field below. Okay, now see, next is in the criteria options of the percentage field, type the greater than equal to 70 so that the records of the student with percent equal to the greater than or 70 are displayed. Means what? In the criteria button, there is a criteria button or criteria option. There is a criteria option in the last, or you can see in the below parts in the query design grid. You can see there are six options: field, table, sort, show, criteria. The last one is or. Okay, so in the criteria options, in the criteria option, you select first you select the criteria, and after that give the condition. Means here you can see what happened: greater than equal to 70. This is nothing, this is what? This is a condition given here. Means what? The marks which is greater than or equal to 70, those marks will be displayed. Okay, now here I want that the roll number, my condition is roll number greater than equal to 10. Those roll number are greater than equal to 10 will be displayed. Means what? 1 to 9 will be skipped by the query or skipped by the this query. So that means what? 1 to 9 is not going to view, because why? This is not in the condition. Means the condition is not fulfilled yet, because 1 is not greater than equal to 10 or 2 is not greater than equal to 10. In the same way, 9 is not greater than equal to 10, but 10 is not greater than, but is equal to 10. So that's why 10 is also coming. From 10 onwards, from number 10 onwards, I want all the information. Okay, so in this way you can create your query and select and also give the condition also. Now it is where? It is the criteria options. So after successfully do all the things, the second thing is running a query. Okay, running a query. Okay, so before going to the running a query, I will say that after selecting the two tables, you can create a relationship. Relationship means what? The roll number here and this roll number and this roll number create a relationship, because this roll number is the same roll number in a marks table and the same roll number in the address table also. So that's why we can create, or we have to create a relationship. If you have more than one table, then you have to first create a relationship, otherwise the information will not going to be displayed. Means what? In the query I want the roll numbers, names, class and also address. This thing I want. You can see the first three field, roll number, name, class, is already exist in this table. Okay, now but address, this field is not belongs to this table. It is where? It is in the address table. That's why we have to collect the address. We have to collect the address from another table. That's why we have to first create the relationship. Okay, go to the relation. There is a relationship button. In the relationship button, you just click the relationship button and just you drag the mouse pointer from roll number to roll number. This roll number means what? You just drag it to the field which is the primary key of the table. Means what? Here the primary key is what? Roll number. Again here roll number is the primary key. Means what? So that we can create a relationship. There are two primary keys in this two table. So that's why we can create the roll number here, and this roll number we can create a relationship. Okay, so that's why it is called a foreign key. So I have already discussed this thing, that more than one primary key is called a foreign key. Okay, now see, after creating relationship, now do the following things. The conditions, give the conditions whatever you want, and after that you can run the query. Next thing is do the running a query. Okay, after successfully design your query, and next part is you have to run the query. Why we run the query? Because when you run the query, it means what? It will display the error message. If you have any error in the query design dialog box or query design grid, then it will going to be displayed. So that's why you have to run the query first. Okay, so that's why run a query or running a query. Okay, now you can see in the book To run a query, click Run in the result group in the design tab. Okay? There is a run option. There is a run option in the result group of the design tab.
When you click the design tab, first we have to click the design tab. After design tab, then go to the result group. Result group. After that, select the run.
Okay? And the output of the query appears in the design screen, the query design screen.
After successfully running the query, you will get the output in the query output window or query design screen.
You can see in the book, the query means what? The last option is query result. You can see there is a run options in the result group, and you have to click the run option. The last part you have to say saving a query.
After successfully run the query, you have to first save the query, because if you not save the query, it will going to lose all the information when your power is gone, or when your power means computer is off, all the information will be lost. Whatever you did in the access is not going to be stored. So that's why you have to store first. Storing is also important, because in future if you need the same thing, same information or same condition you want, then why you waste your time? Why waste your time? Just go to the saving where you save the query and just just run the query. It will automatically collect the information again and display the all the information. So that's why. So first we have to save the query. So the last part is saving a query. Saving the query. Saving the query means what? To save a query, click the file tab and select the file save options and a save button on the quick access toolbar. There are two ways. First is go to the file menu or file options. After that, you just click the save options. Or directly in the quick access toolbar, there is a quick access toolbar. In the quick access toolbar, there is a save option. Just to click the save options, it will automatically save the query. So in this way, you can save the query for future use. Okay, understand? Now this is the steps of query design. So I think you understand these things. Next thing is query wizard. Query wizard is another way to create a query.
First one is query design and second one is query wizard.
Number two is query wizard. Query wizard.
Second option is query wizard.
We can create a query in two ways. First one is already discussed, query design. And second one is query wizard.
Okay, in query wizard you can see there is again the steps is given here. The steps to create a query in the query wizard group or wizard are, first you have to click the query wizard in the query group of the create tab.
Means what? The steps means what? Why I am discussing the steps here? Because steps are so important, because I am actually means what? In a query the steps are so important.
I've already said it, when you discuss Access 2010 or Access, MS Access, if you are not understand the query, it means what? Your concept is totally zero. So query is so important. So that's why I am discuss the query means what? And also discuss the steps also. So steps also are very important. So that's why I am going to discuss the steps also. So that's why I am giving the steps also. You can see in the next thing is the steps to create a query with the help of a query wizard dialog box or query wizard. Now first we have to click the create tab.
First step is what? Create tab. In the create tab, there is a option query groups or query groups. Query groups.
Okay, in the queries group, there is a option query wizard. query wizard. Just you click the query wizard. After clicking the query wizard, there is a new query dialog box will be appear. You can see in the book there is a new query dialog box will be appear. Select, there are four options: simple query wizard, cross type query wizard, find duplicate query wizard, and find unmatched query wizard. No need to go any other options, just click simple query wizard. Just click simple query wizard, and after that you can see when you click the simple query wizard dialog box, the simple query wizard dialog box will be appear. You can see the figure 11.45, there is a wizard dialog box. It is called simple query wizard dialog box. You can see there are only one, that is one field is available, student ID, because only student ID is available here. But when you select more than one table, there are lot of field available. Okay, whatever the field you want, you just select the field name or select the field options, and after that click the this part, click the this options. Here you can see there are these symbols are given here. In these symbols you can select the query. This means what? Select one. It means what? Select all. This means what? Undo. Undo one field. This means what? Undo all field. Okay, so these are the options given here. You can see here, after selecting the fields, whatever the fields you want, I want the roll number, name, class, and address. So I am selecting four fields. After that what? After that click the next button, and you can see in the third screen simple query wizard appears. This is called third screen. You can see 11.47, that is a simple query wizard screen will appear. You can see type a query name in the text box and select open the query to view the information and click finish. Okay, means what? In the query there is a default query one query will given in the query simple query wizard dialog box, but you can give your own query name. Okay, I am giving here student marks. Student marks is my query name or the title you want to for your query. I want this title in the my query, students mark. Okay, students marks. Okay, now after selecting these options, now go to the 7 steps. Okay, this is the last steps I given here. Okay, now in 6 steps you can see the query will appear in the datasheet view. Okay, after clicking these options, okay, now click the finish button. After this, the last button, last one is click the finish option. Okay, when you click the finish option or finish button, just you can see you can appear the query in the datasheet view. Means why does it view? Because in the datasheet view you can enter the information whatever you enter. Okay, so in this way, in the query wizard dialog box or query wizard options used to create a query. So in this session or in this topic, we learned that how to create a query What are two ways we can create a query? First one is query design and second one is query widget. Okay, so I think you understand both the query, creating a query options. If you have any problem, I can say if you have any problem, please do comment. And please come in the training sessions. I'm always giving the links before time. Again, I say only few students present in the dog training sessions. I don't know why. I'm always in every video, I'm always request you that please come to join the dog training sessions. Somebody come, and after few minutes, that they will left. I don't know why. Why they are coming and why they are not attend this class. You are not interested or any problem. If your internet connection is very slow, then it's okay, it's not the problem. But I think you have to attend this dog training sessions. Okay, so it is so important, please take it seriously. Okay, so in this class we learn these things. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. I think you understand these things. Okay, any problem, just please do comment. Okay, thank you everybody, thank you for watching this video. Have a great day. Lastly, again I say, stay at home and be safe. Thank you everybody. Have a great day. Thank you.